And it's about the Holy Spirit.
What's your question about the Holy Spirit?
John 14, verse 26. It says emphatically that the Comforter is the Holy Spirit. But
if it says that, that means there is a contradiction. You read in your Bible, open your Bible, Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is explained for you that I go away. For if I go not, the Comforter shall not come. For if I depart, shall I send him? If it refers to the Comforter was already before Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, came. I told that earlier, the Holy Spirit was there in the womb of Elizabeth. Brother, the Holy Spirit was there when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was being baptized. It's mentioned in the Gospel. So surely it cannot refer to the Holy Spirit. That means there's a contradiction in the Bible. Like how I told you in my lecture, Jesus, peace be upon him, says that John the Baptist is the Elias. When they ask John the Baptist, art thou Elias? He says, no. There's a contradiction. Who's right, who's wrong? You have to solve the problem. Because I do not consider the Bible to be the word of God. You consider it to be the word of God. So you have to solve that problem.
Because you quoted that John to explain. That's why I'm also trying to. Because
no, I'm quoting John, chapter 14, verse number 16. John, chapter 15, verse 26. John, chapter 16, verse number 7. All is in context only.
Chapter 14, verse 16, also the description it gave. It says it will abide with us forever.
Correct.
But Muhammad never abided with us forever.
He is abiding with us forever.
He died.
This is the teachings of Prophet Muhammad. This is the revelation which he got, the Quran. And he's saying the Hadith. It's abiding with the human being forever. No one can change the Quran. The Injil has been changed, not the Quran. That means after Prophet Muhammad, no other messenger will come.